Hello everyone, this is Tae Kwon from Keene, New Hampshire. I'm going to share a case that I just treated yesterday. And the patient name is Caitlin. And Caitlin unfortunately lost maxillary right central incisor due to resorption, making the tooth unrestorable. And 9 months ago, I did extraction and large bone augmentation on this area, and the site appeared to be ready for dental implant. And this is how it looks preoperatively before I start making incision. When I look at this case, where the soft tissue around the adjacent teeth, maxillary left central incisor and maxillary right lateral incisor, the soft tissue healing looks excellent. Now, the one thing that I don't want to do is with an incision, I can cause gingival recession around these adjacent teeth. What I mean by that is normally most of the clinician will actually go and then make intrasulcular incision around the central incisor, do the crestal incision, and then the intrasulcular incision around this lateral incisor. And then when you elevate the full thickness flap and you place the implant and place this flaps back, you're actually risking potential recession around these adjacent teeth, especially interproximal area. Luckily, in Caitlin's case, the soft tissue seems to be pretty thick, so there's a less chance of gingival recession, but I don't want to take any chance with her case causing any gingival recession. So before I start the treatment, I have to think about how I'm going to make an incision. Two, one thing that I want to see is how much bone is available. And this is done by obtaining a CT scan. So the CT scan allows me to treatment plan the right size of the implant and right length of the implant preoperatively and simulate it first. And based on the shape of the bone and alveolar structure and underlying anatomical landmark, I have decided to place 3.3 by 10 millimeter, 12 millimeter implant in this location. Now, when you look at this sagittal view closely, you can actually see there is a little bit of concavity on this area. I want to make sure that when I'm placing the implant, I do not cause fenestration around this area with my drill. So how do I make an incision design to A, minimize gingival recession on the adjacent teeth, but B, to give me enough access so that I can visualize this apical area? This is how my incision looked like. So you can clearly see I dropped two vertical incision and crestal incision, and then the vertical incisions are away from the adjacent teeth, leaving at least 2 to 3 millimeter of gingiva there. And this is what we call a papillary preservation incision. And by dropping two verticals, I can clearly see the apical portion of the alveolus by reflecting in a flap. And now I'm going to place the implant. An implant has been placed very successfully. Primary stability was about 20 newton centimeter. So I'm going to submerge this implant for further osseous healing. Now, when you look at a little bit closely, there's a slight green fracture on the buccal plate. What do? I want to protect that buccal plate, because from the scientific study, if implant has more than 2 millimeter of buccal plate thickness, then there's a minimal risk or reduced risk of causing gingival recession around dental implant. And knowing that this is a highly aesthetic area, I want to make sure I minimize that. So after I placed the implant in a prosthetically driven position, I added some xenograft to thicken the buccal plate in this area. And then after that, I simply closed the flap back, and this is how the case was finished. I used some chromic gut sutures on the vertical incision, and then I used monocrystal sutures on the crestal aspect. And she had a flipper, and then I wanted to make sure the flipper fits back there, and I confirmed the sitting. And this is the radiographs. So preoperative radiograph, intraoperatory radiograph with a guide pin, and then three, placement of the dental implant with a cover screw, and implant is further submerged. And then we're going to wait about 3 months for osseous healing before we do the second stage surgery to expose this implant. So I hope you enjoy my short case synopsis of Caitlin. Take care.